How close will the MVP race be?
I think it'll be closer than what people think. I still believe James Harden will win. I'm probably on the side of leaning towards voting for LeBron James. You know, we had in our production meeting, I told the guys, let's just play the what if game. What if LeBron James was on Houston with the team with Chris Paul? And what if James Harden was on the Cleveland team? Kevin Love, Clarkson, Nance. I still think the Houston team would be 64, 65 wins. But would the Cleveland team be where they are, the third or fourth slot, I believe, right now? I'm not sure. Don't get me wrong, James Harden would still have his numbers, but would the team be as good? What if?
Okay.
So, yeah. I'm a little old school. Michael Jordan should have won the MVP every single year.
Yeah.
I know Charles won it 1 year, and then what happened? Got embarrassed by Jordan in the finals.
Karl Malone.
Karl Malone won it twice. Walt threw Jordan. And what did MJ do? Beat him twice.
Yeah.
Not that LeBron is going to beat anyone out west, because I don't believe Cleveland can beat Houston or Golden State if they got to the finals. But LeBron James is the best player. Michael Jordan was the best player but didn't win it every year. And you got to reward James Harden, and that's why I think he will win it, because of the team's success. 65 wins, maybe 66 tonight, and body of work. He's been runner-up the last 2 years.
Yeah.
That's why he will win it, but I gave you my reasons on why I'm probably leaning towards LeBron.
I think LeBron's been more valuable, but we go with the best player on the best team or the best record.
On the best team.
Yeah, and I hold LeBron accountable for what happens with the front, you know, the moves that they make, because he's involved in it whether he admits it or not.
Yes.
And you know, to bring people in and then it just didn't go well. This second wave, this younger group that came in, you know, it's not his fault that Kevin Love got hurt or Tristan Thompson, you know, hasn't played well at all. But, you know, Isaiah Thomas never felt comfortable there. You make these moves, and it feels like LeBron's – I have to hold him accountable for that. And that's probably why I wouldn't have him win it, but I think he's been more valuable than Harden.
This would be a no-brainer situation if James Harden went down December 31st. And that's when Cleveland really imploded that month of January.
Yeah.
If they didn't implode and LeBron played like LeBron that – you know, we've seen the last month and a half, 2 months, I would have gone with LeBron, because he had an opportunity when James Harden was down. James Harden came back, and then remember that 60-point triple-double,
yeah.
And his team took off 17 or 18-game win streak, and the rest is history. So I agree with you 100%, because LeBron is – you've got to hold him accountable for the implosion that the Cavs went through that month of January. They somewhat righted the ship. But it needed to be done when they brought in the young players and Clarkson and Larry Nance Jr. But as much as we're going to praise LeBron, and which I do, you've got to also hold him accountable, because that was on his watch what happened to the Cavs.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Dan Patrick Show app.